All right, folks, the deck is Ping Mage. The goal of the deck is to draw Wildfire early, replay it with a Rewind and Magister Dawngrass so we can blast our opponent in the face. If you're watching this on YouTube, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. You can catch me live at twitch.tv/Rawful. All right. Let's ping some faces. Should probably get that DVD logo off.
Khadgar versus Nazoth.
Let the crystals claim your mind.
There's no turning back now.
Alright, let's see what's in the box. I don't want to get extra fire spells because of the limitation on, or that makes it less likely I get Wildfire back. Okay, it's Reno. Probably just going for a Wild Growth here. We are a deck that can actually beat the, jeez. What's his name? Hey, there's the Wildfire. The Sargeras. So that's good news for me. Get that down, look for the rewind while it's reasonably likely to.
Crack it up to
11! Sure.
Seeing stars!
Doesn't seem as likely I'll need the second wisdom since I have double Book of Spectres, so. Okay. Generalize online.
I see you.
Our gift of the arcane enlightens us. Someone get aggro! Spirit of the flame! Burn them to ash!
Okay. It's honestly not a bad target for it.
You here for the tour?
Okay, that is a clear. Symphony?
I like calculations. You need to chill out.
Should have pinged face to set up lethal. fine. We just have turn 10 lethal now.
Our gift of frost shields us.
Wide. We wouldn't have had the lethal to set up anyway, but it was still the right play.
Rothel, have you ever thought about starting a mariachi band with your channel VIPs to make your deck intros a bit more entertaining?
I have not. I'm not saying it's not a good idea. But that's the reason. Thank you, Janae. Oh, they gave me lethal. That was nice of them.
Your bones get into the pile.
I don't think they needed to play the Raise Dead there. Just gonna say, throw that out there. Counterpoint, it was green. Okay, well, can't argue with that.
Watch your back.
Literally no one can. Back now. Any humans?
Well met.
Magashog, thank you for the 10 months.
X marks the spot.
Well done.
That weird coin play is generally a tell. You always hit a bot when you have the most fun hand? Yeah. Well, that's just because I hit a lot of bots. Case in point, here's another one.
There's no turning back now.
Yep.
Well done. You win.
2 out of 3 opponents have been bots. And you know, some of them are bots. Because they play decks that only bots play. Oh my god. That's disgusting for me.
Hello, hello, hello.
There's no turning back now.
Any wildfires? I really hope this opponent isn't running Cho'Gall in their deck, because after this game, there's a good chance they will remove him from the deck if they are.
None will survive.
This deck is kind of nice versus Questline Druid, right? I don't know why it would beat Questline Druid. Or how it would beat Questline Druid. Freezing Face. I mean, we have 1, 2, 4 cards that freeze face. That's not reliable. That's a really good pickup for here.
The light dims, but we fight.
Just notice the opponent also has a broken hero power. Oh, right.
Reporting for duty. Reporting for duty.
Oof. Sure. Oh my god, the Brand Varden is nuts too. This is actually pretty silly.
Let the lights save you.
Okay, that's a little bit annoying. Awful, you bully. Look, we don't need to feel sorry for Odd Paladin. There's a decent chance they're still just winning this game. We especially don't need to feel sorry for... I guess they're playing around objection. So, don't need to say anything to me in here.
What secrets will uncover?
my calculations, you need to chill out!
I think we treat these like they're 3-3s for now. Since it's not terribly costly to do so, I would like to protect the Bran. But that's ambitious. Very bad for me.
Hello, hello!
Open your minds to the light.
Your history.
Cool.
No problem.
No.
Oh, I didn't actually need to do that because of the brand still on the board. I think I probably was a little too passive on clearing their minions and maybe could have just like started chaining, planning on an ice block chain to set up a bunch of pings to face. I don't know.
Khadgar versus Taranda.
You give me strength.
There's no turning back now.
Guess we assume Shadow Priest? I don't know what priests are anymore, but probably Shadow Priest. No? Big Priest? That would be silly. The only card that really does anything, even if it's only 2 damage. Oh, I've been seeing a lot of automaton priests recently. That's one where we probably just give up the board to them. Protocol.
Job done.
Speaking of creation, Wait, that doesn't count as damage? Mind shields don't count, same for Hunter Questline? Yeah, I knew for the Hunter Questline. I just never really thought about it with Janelai before, I guess.
The legacy of the Titan can never die.
Wait. Everything's gonna die, then the death rattle goes off, right? They've only had one die so far, though.
Observe and reflect.
Cool.
But then I get, like, this is horrible. What an absolute nightmare. I just have no way of clearing these. It's the ones they played? Yeah. Oh, God. Yeah, but no, if I... It doesn't... Oh, I could have cleared.
You're right.
Because they haven't played any... No, they have played copies. So it would summon two. And then it would grow. I would... Yeah. No, I'm... My play was... Correct. Because they've played at least one copy from hand as a result of the power of creation. This is kind of a problem again, so I can't even go Bran into Inquisitive. Just need to go Bran into Dawngrasp, I guess. That's probably GG. Greatest virtue is pain. Could get some more ice blocks back from the rewind off of Dawngrasp.
Who knows what
do you wish to match wits with me?
Done.
Alright. Unlucky. Opium. Guess this is a spot where an ice walker would have been nice, but I'm overdrawing. Oh, absolutely unreal.
I need more study.
The Ice Walker probably would have been GG in my favor. That was, really unfortunate. I had the Reckless in hand. And I was at 7 health, so it was unlikely they had a way to get lethal. Kind of getting exhausting queuing into Automaton Priest with goofy decks.
There's no turning back now.
Like, it's not quite like a questline warlock, but it has very like similar in the fact that it just absolutely devastates slow developing decks. Please don't be an even shaman bot.
We have turned our curse into our strength.
Every time I get a good hand. That's the bummer about losing a close match to like a really unlucky overdraw is that like that's who knows when I'm going to find another human opponent. Well, now I guess. Watch it be another automaton. Okay, this is one of my least favorite anomalies. Mostly because I don't, like, play that many board-based decks. This would be just absolutely devastating as an anomaly if it's another automaton priest, though. To get me more copies of Wildfire.
My power is as infinite as the stars.
Ow. It's just always the worst case scenario, isn't it?
Yeah.
And we just play against a non-priest. I mean, it's not priest. It's this very specific and niche priest deck that we keep queuing into that is a very bad matchup for me. Okay, at least we have a big enough creation to clear some of this here. Be a lot better if they didn't get, like, a massive high roll on the, anomaly, though. Why is this suddenly so popular in Wild? It's, not popular. I just happen to keep queuing into it. Is it even worth playing it out? I mean, if I can see it against bad matchups, and I can see it against bots, I won't have any games left to play. At the very least, it looks like they might not have Rodden, so there won't be the awkward like blocks to our clears that we faced last time. Is this just the same opponent? Like, the cannibalize doesn't seem that common in the deck, is it? And it would not be my first choice. Gotta get pings in. Have several more ice blocks at least. But like, this guy's already too big for even a more Dresh to clear. Board lock? Wait, I can't. If I board lock them, I take 7 damage and I lose the game. Like, there's, this doesn't actually do anything. It's not a real card that helps me here. So let's Mordresh clear the turn after. Seems pretty unlikely to matter. Because I'd be dead. I don't know, maybe I can make it work. But I have to play it on turn 10 with an ice block. It's not going to be relevant for a while. I'd be better off just drawing another Reckless Apprentice, I think. Also seems like they're just not going to extend far enough for it to matter in the slightest. Come on, what? I need a break. I'm so tilted by the matchups and the obnoxious BM. It's bad enough we queue a very unfavored matchup that is very, very niche, 2 out of 3 games, but we don't need somebody needlessly extending out the game. We drew a wildfire in an opening hand, so it's almost certainly a bot. Yeah, I've never seen the skin before either. Got double wildfire. Yep, it's... I just want to play against humans, man. Why is this so hard? I want to play against humans that aren't exactly automaton priest. I'm telling you, every single time I've drawn... That chatter was actually right. The better my hand is, the more likely it is a bot. Bots play Hunter now. There's like a standard aggro Hunter that bots play on Wild.
Your nightmare begins.
There's no turning back now.
Okay, we drew wildfire, so we're up against a bot.
My awakening.
Surely. Oh, I see you. Finally. I've actually got a really good reduced cost wisdom here. Should have saved the ping, I think.
All it takes is love, care, and death.
Yeah, always. Is that just a guaranteed way to draw the Embiggen? That's kind of cute. It's actually developed. It does run the risk of drawing one of the blocks, but it'll be fine. It's better to have minions on board in a match up against a board-based deck. What is this deck? I think it's everything Druid. Super cool bad boy, thank you for the prime. Oh no!
I can't take them. Wait, not all of them!
All our Janalai and Mordresh are online. They do get another refill the turtles here pretty soon, but still, that was gross.
For a master tactician, this is nothing.
That's something. It's the one time where I won't say order lol in that situation because they want the stats. Either outcome is pretty fine for me. Can they just wait until next turn for the aquatic though? Yes, that probably would have been the... Well.
Reflect in the moon well.
Good lord.
Well met.
Chrono Chaotic. Thank you for the 2 months. Embiggen is ruining their Alun. Oh. Wait. Yeah, because of the extra mana cost. I think they're trying to get zero mana minions off of it. or one mana minions into two mana minions. Or reduce cost minions, I'm not sure. A GG courier. Alright, human.
Khadgar versus Elise.
Two in a row, maybe? Okay. I don't mind that.
Class is in session.
There's no turning back now.
I don't really want to play this on one anyway, because I would rather just draw the card, so let's cycle these. Another embiggened game. So that's a hand.
Wait, not all of them.
Snow problem.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here. Truth is found in death.
I think I just accept the overdraw here. My hand is too good right now. I'm overdrawing two cards is the problem. And now I'm overdrawing one. I can't give this up. This is way too important with the other experimenter.
Thank you.
hand is full.
All of these minions are incredibly... That's really unfortunate.
Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here.
We have a lot of ice blocks. Does Rat even make real sense in this deck? I think it's just for the extra stats. Really would like to get that to their I need them to ideally grab the board and then we can go in on that ice walker combo. But I really want the other wildfire here.
By my calculations, you need to chill out.
It's maybe bait with the first wildfire. Or, not wildfire. Ice Walker.
Job's done.
So I need their board pull if I want the second one to pay off. Is there even a chance?
Yeah. How about a new life? How about a new life?
Just kind of explain how we get there. Build the board, freeze it with the Ice Walker Reckless, figure it out from there. Chain ice blocks. I really need a wildfire though, like soon. That'll do. There is going to be a bit of concern with the amount of draw, I guess, because the ice blocks matter a lot less in that instance. Yeah, the fatigue is going to be a bit of a concern. But it will be for the opponent as well. didn't get there. I forgot about the anomaly and how much that disrupted my draw. And rendered the ice blocks completely useless. I cannot believe how hard they high rolled on the double and big in turn one. And the, god, that anomaly was just devastating for me in trying to set up the ice blocks. Been getting really unlucky with the anomalies, the times where they have popped up today. Like, it just kind of hard carried that one game against Automaton Priest. And back to the box.
Show me your strength.
There's no turning back now.
And the dirty right? Yeah, I mean, to be fair, I could have played the Mordrush the turn before, but I greeted it. How can you tell it's a bot so fast? A vast majority of my opponents are against bots, and a lot of skins are very easy or often telegraph that it's a bot. This one might not be, though. Oh. Might as well be a bot. Turn one aquatic into coin forage. Yeah, it simply doesn't matter though. This deck plays itself. It's so. They will still win this game despite making that decision. As the best deck in the format, they didn't need to draw the nuts against me, but I'm sure it helps. Okay, there's a wildfire finally.
Give that minion a turn to get brutal. Ready.
My might.
I just need to go next. There's no possible way I could win this.
Well done. You win.
That deck is ludicrous.
No turning back now.
Alright, just keep the wildfire. Look for... It's the complement it, this is fine. Down. Maybe it can give me a little bit of damage here at the course of the game. Okay, so it's the fatigue version. Not sure that that's a problem for me. Hoping to avoid those, and since they discarded the raised dead. Oh. Well, that explains why they discarded the raised dead. Disco is still viable. This is not disco luck. And no, it's not viable in either format.
I ain't talking.
Thank you. Icebox should help me, right? I think they're gonna hit fatigue a little too quickly.
Flesh fails. Try crystal.
Guess when you've drawn this many cards, it's bound to happen. They're probably not going to hit the fatigue too quickly, it seems. Maybe they are.
Out of cards! Whoa! Too many cards!
I cannot do that.
Job's done.
You need to chill out.
You can't stop this snowstorm.
Let's play this to make sure we have the Zavara online next turn. Welcome, Major Fuss. I don't think I have any other frost spells in here, so I just have another ice block in here, so I don't think there's much, if anything, they can do from here that will prevent them from losing. I think they're just kind of doing a really elaborate long concede.
Thank you.
Oh my god. Surely it can't be yet another automaton priest, right? Extra mana crystal could be helpful.
There's no turning back now.
Really feels like I need the wildfire no matter what the matchup is, or something that can help me draw the wildfire. These are helpful if it is automaton priest. I would just very much rather it not be though.
I see you brought guests.
Okay. Palm reading. That's just incorrect.
Give Forsaken Scar Metal a chance, man.
Job done.
I was just throwing this out to die anyway. Oh god, the Mordresh. That's brutal.
I can't take him.
So many of my cards are good for the opponent. It's gonna be very awkward.
I've got plenty of mojo to go around.
Done.
Up in like a 5-mana draw too. Man, this hand is horrendous.
Time to wash away the filth.
What are they doing? They have to be trolling here, right? Quite the high roll. I'm gonna lose this game.
Together in harmony.
What secrets does the cosmos hold?
Muzzle their magic.
Take
I'm not trying to be toxic, but the opponent sincerely made some of the worst early game plays I could fathom.
There is no light, only power!
Is my suggestion.
Well, either we win or we clear this off. What did they think was gonna happen? That was one of the most bizarre games I've ever played. It was great to watch though, was it? I feel like the opponent just like kept throwing punches at me and cracking themselves in the face. Like, it's a little rough to watch. And like, I sincerely don't know how to commentate that match without coming across as super toxic, because like there was a lot of things that they did that was just objectively incorrect. And am I just supposed to pretend it didn't happen? All right, I'm gonna queue's broken. I'm gonna get some water.
Well met.
Now that's content.
Obviously, that was my opponent's fault. Mindvor, thank you for the 4 months. Sorry, I was away. I always like to imagine when that happens, I was queuing into a bot and the bot got banned. That's what makes me feel better.
Versus Lorthamar.
Glory to the Sindori. There's no turning back now.
It's kind of a good hand, isn't it?
The living grab all kinds of things.
Oh, this is the bot deck again.
Well done. You win.
I can't. I play against humans. At least this will give me early insight into whether or not it's human. I won't even have to wait for their turn one. It's a good aggro deck that isn't Totem Shaman or Pirate Rogue. Well, Pirate Rogue's not a good aggro deck, first of all, but probably Shadow Priest.
I see you brought gas.
I can't actually ever play this because it might override my hero power. Okay, at least they got a somewhat equally dead card. Wait, didn't they not want to play it though? Why are they playing it? What's the point of this quest? What is going on these past couple games?
We have truly left Value Town in the dust and have crossed the border to Tempoville.
Take me back. Take me back. Thank you, Ono. I don't like any of these plays, to be honest with you. All of my cards are way too important right now.
Observe and reflect.
Okay, what if? My hand is just stuck, so I just have to do this. I really need to use the Nourish for draw because my hand is just pure blanks. I need to wait on a Wildfire for this. The hero power cannot be more valuable than just getting progress on that, can it? It just doesn't make sense. Good lord, these are terrible. I cannot catch a break with this hand right now. Stop! Give me something! This is unreal. None of my... Oh, my God.
All it takes is love, care, and death.
Finally. But, like, hey, without the wildfire, it hasn't pinged. Maybe they want the quest to proc after they play Guff. Then you simply mulligan the quest away. So that you have a better chance of drawing the Guff. And also you just don't run cards like that in the same deck. Alright, well we have to ramp off of this now. I'm gonna burn the wildfire, aren't I? I have to dump this, and I'm just never going to allow it to complete. This is a really... I just drew the worst part of my deck possible for this matchup. In what is already a really bad matchup, I just drew about as bad as I possibly could.
This must be the way.
This is a miserable experience. There's no reason to play this out. I've already lost.
Well done. You win.
I cannot fathom a world where that deck building makes the slightest bit of sense. It's just not, like, you don't run Guff with the questline because it just doesn't matter. We're moving on. You lasted longer than I would have. I mean, it would have been... It's a very, 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 very extraordinarily bad matchup for me. Like, the whole point of playing Druid is that it beats slow mages. But I might have had a chance if I had just drawn, like, cards that I could have played. And this is the bot skin. So, rip.
Death is nature's way.
There's no turning back now.
Tunnel Trog or the turtle guy. Yeah, this is a definite bot play.
Well done. You win.
This has been a very, very frustrating stream today, I'm going to be honest with you. When I do queue into humans, they're playing a deck that, like, randomly hard counters us. I've queued into so many bots, it's unreal.
Hello. There's no turning back now.
Like, this deck is built with the good decks in mind, and I've queued into them zero times. Alright, let's look for Wildfire. Surely we can draw it at some point, right? That draws towards it at least.
Power for the taking.
Reporting for duty.
You can't stop these snows.
All right. I mean, we have playable cards for a change. Grab a cheap spell outside of our normal spell school.
Reporting for duty.
So that we can play it pretty quickly and easily. I don't think I want to play that just yet. Holy Wrath Paladin? Does Hammer of Wrath make sense in that deck? Or help that deck, maybe. I don't know. We've seen exactly one card, though. I think it's probably too early to make an accurate prediction of what the deck is. Hold the ice block for Cervara. I hold it for mana efficiency. There's no reason to play a zero mana one when there's... Yeah, it's just big building. When there's the potential that I top deck the main deck one.
Seeing stars. What a delightful party.
Time to wash away the filth.
No problem.
Job done.
So until I need the frost in the spell school, it just makes sense to hold on to it in case, because there's like no benefit to playing it early, whereas there is an upside to holding it, and unless like we're facing down a lot of damage that could turn into lethal.
Light bends to my sweet moves.
That's not good for me. I was really hoping they were running out of minions. On curve, Kangor is very difficult to beat, though. I think Kangor just goes back to hand if there's no... Oh, maybe he does just die. When I had a crazy hand, yeah, that's been happening a lot today.
secrets we'll uncover.
I can take them. Wait, not all of them!
Minds to the light.
I was worried they weren't going to take the brand off the board there for a moment. They didn't pop the block, though. I think that's GG. No, because they can... I need to kill my minions so they can't rush with the Kangor. I think I would have won anyway, but they needed to get a Kangor down here. Or the previous turn. Because they have another copy of the dance floor off of the service bell. So I didn't want to leave the Kangor on the board, have them minions on the board, have them rush into my minions and deny the lethal with the Mordresh ping.
The light bends.
Opponent isn't a secret eater enjoyer? Yeah. Yes. Eater of Secrets is great, getting pulled off a Kangor. Almost as good as when you play it from hand, but really the difference is pretty negligible. In one case, you spend 4 mana. I did not think we were going to pull that out. My god.
Khadgar versus Medivh.
Your time grows short. There's no turning back now.
Okay, just get a bunch of wildfires.
Ah, I see you brought guests.
It'll be our little secret.
It is just Seeker Mage? Okay. Need to test for the counterspell the turn that I play the ice block, I think.
snowstorm.
It's fine.
I'll show them. I'll show them all.
Guess who?
Have a test for the counter just yet, so I would like to find another spell, but that turn was way too clean to pass up on. A counter. Counterspell rig, fair game. Maybe an ice block because we saw a duplicate.
It'll be our little secret.
Just getting goofy. They're just running all of the secrets. So we know that one's rigged fair game or ice block. Not worry too much about maximizing damage just yet. Sure. You've seen both counter spells.
Ever jousted a dragon?
These past three games have just been something else, man.
A toast to all who sought to kill me.
You failed.
Spirit of the flame, turn back!
Two for two. Yet annihilated. Oh. Oh, that's so satisfying. Oh, I think that's a good one to end on.